What is equally scary at both day and night? We need to talk. Why don't you have a seat? Mom. Something happened. When you're not feeling well. As someone with a bowel and bladder disability, I've come to fear any and all sounds from that part of the body. It's a 24/7 living. They say it gets easier. On the list of body parts one want to replace with robot parts, digestive system is number one. Rotating machinery. Rotating machinery doesn't care about you, your feelings, or your flesh and bones. It has one job to do, and it's going to do it. If you don't respect it, it will you up. Yes. Using a lathe during the day or at night is equally scary. 10. Missed calls from your mom. My mom would do that, just wondering what I would want for dinner. My mom just waits until I'm not hungry before she asks me what I want to eat. Your mother calling you by your full names. And even scarier when she calls you by all your siblings' names before getting to your full name. My mom just likes to loop through all our names out loud until she eventually gets to the one she wants. Being home alone and hearing something fall on the floor. Being home alone and hearing any noises that aren't coming from you or your personal belongings. Yay. I'm so worried about stuff like this that I don't even wear my headset when I game so I can hear IRL. The sudden and unexpected sound of a rattlesnake. If it has started to rattle, you are already pissing it off. If it started to rattle, it's giving you the chance to back off first. Most snakes will just bite you. Rattlesnakes are the good guys of the venomous snake world. Not here anymore. Feral hogs have taken the warning buzzer as a dinner bell. So if one rattles, you might be standing too close. Aneurysms. The thought of dying unexpectedly at any moment without being able to say goodbye to my loved ones is terrifying. My dad got extremely lucky. He took a fall down some stairs one day and his knee started to swell up a few days later, so he went to have it checked out. When checking his knee, they found a huge aneurysm in his leg that hadn't burst yet. They scanned his whole body and found three more. Two small ones in his pelvic area and another huge one in his abdomen. Thankfully, he had them removed and is checked out every so often now. That spill down the stairs saved his life. They can appear all over, WTF. What I'm gathering from this post is that being alive is scary as the horror. The sudden feeling that you're useless to society. That feeling goes away. No. But you can learn to ignore it. Doubt is eternal. Someone pointing a weapon at you. Like, either way, there's a possibility you're gonna die. No thank you. Hey, Cyrus's brain, pull the trigger. Safety, always off. Figuring out you have been followed by the same man for more than 10 minutes in cars, progressively slowing down as they reach you walking by. It's scary as when cars just like slow to a crawl to pass you on the road. Especially when it's a wide van with black opaque windows when you're wearing shorts and walking your extremely cute dog. Waking up thinking that you are late for something. Like, have you ever dozed off at 8 p.m. and woken up at 10 p.m, looked at your clock and thought it was 10 a.m. and you slept in and are now late for work, school? That's equally as scary as actually waking up late in the morning and running late. I did that during finals week once. My final was at 4 p.m, and I woke up at 4:30 a.m. That time of year in that town, it was dark at that time either way. By the time I realized my mistake, I was so shaken up that I couldn't get back to sleep, so I channeled my anxiety and just studied until it was time to wake up and study. I aced the final, but it did take me the full 2 hours. Dolls. Especially porcelain. I once stayed in an Airbnb in Japan. The house was fine, but the owners had dolls everywhere. The corridor outside my room, the living room. I got real close to one and their eyes seemed to be following you. Those Hina dolls. Holy off. I didn't dare to go to the toilet at night because of them. Just because they are near perfectly formed empty human bodies waiting for something to take possession of them doesn't make dolls scary at all. A naked hobo running at you. I would definitely say that would be much scarier at night. Wasps are fuck wasps. And the new joy of Asian hornets. I live in a part of Asia where we have those guys and I just try to stay as far away from them. Only ever seen a couple of them though. People knocking at the door. I know it's probably a delivery, but it still freaks me out. I'd say it's scarier at night, emo. My bank account. The unstoppable marching of time that is slowly guiding us all towards an inevitable death. Memento mori. Unus annus, unus annus. floating alone in the ocean. Shark could attack you anytime. There is a good possibility you'd never see it coming day or night. I don't think the shark attack is what terrifies me there. Firstly, WTF are you doing floating alone in the ocean? Jokes aside, suffocation has got to be the scariest one. Fire is up there. Missing the last step walking down the stairs. 37 missed calls from your girlfriend, wife. 36 is the safe limit. Feeling the presence of someone who has entered through the rear when you're home alone. Student debt. WTF, bro. I won't be able to sleep tonight. Children's laughter coming from your basement. When you don't have kids. I may not have kids, but I do have child laborers. Cancer. My own thoughts. Being buried alive. The Spanish Inquisition. Didn't expect that one. A strange white van driving around giving out free candy. I would say that's slightly more scary at night. Minecraft discs 11 and 13. Also, the phantoms. I was mining for a really long time and didn't sleep. When I got to the surface, the sun was already setting and then there was an army of phantoms chasing me. Crashing. Having to go to the hospital in the US. Our insurance policy. Insurance is a joke. Okay, so that's gonna be a lot of money, so you know what will help. Take all the money you didn't spend and give it to the billionaires. Apparently jogging while black. The closet when the door is slightly open. Scenario where that's not scarier at night. When the sun is setting, casting an ominous orange glow inside your house, and you feel the stillness of everything as the winds stop and the noises of animals and people alike coming to a halt as they take their rest. It is then that the closet door being ajar becomes scary. In the near liminal atmosphere of the hour, your brain prepares for a creature of unknown features to cross the threshold of that door. Suddenly goes blind. My mom walking into my room. The lonely stoner seemingly freeing his mind. The reflection in my mirror. Clowns. The eldritch horrors I conjure up in my brain space. Taxes. Any insect much larger in size than expected. Your parents loudly calling your name in a very serious tone. That makes me jump out of my own skin. The basement, I don't care if it's safe. Once I turn the lights off, I only have 1 second to run up the stairs before the demons get me. Diabetes. A naked clown running toward you down a long hallway with a locked door at your back. Right now. If my daughter says she has a headache, my first thought is, oh, now we all have corona. Really, it's just sinus pressure. But my anxiety likes to pop up every now and then. Trying to eat food, but then that one piece of food decides to get stuck in your throat. When I was a kid, my mom with a ruler in her hand. Police lights, sirens coming up behind you. The inevitable heat death of the universe.